Hey, pre-hired, we've got Mike with us in Frisco, Texas. He just joined the top sales team a couple weeks ago. Just going to ask him a couple questions about his experience. Mike, first, would you just tell us a little bit about you and your background?
Yeah, so I've kind of dabbled across quite a few industries. I've done sales. I've been training specialist for an independent software company that did records management software. It's kind of on track to be an analyst role. We got bought out. But while I did that, I was kind of a liaison between the developers and the clients, kind of saw the value in not just sales, but software sales specifically, and how that's just going to blow up. And then when we got bought out, it kind of redirected my role. So had to start over, and I went to a full commission position and kind of was always trying to get back into software. And while at my last position, Prehired, actually, I guess they found me on LinkedIn doing a bunch of searches and said, hey, you know, we, you know, I think you're looking for your car. I think we have the keys. So after, yeah, it was kind of, you know, it was kind of random, but, you know, as I, you know, researched it, looked into it a bit, saw the value. It's like some of the stuff you may feel like you know a little bit, but they have those extra ingredients that you're going to need that really help you solidify, you know, just the best approach in sales. And you can literally take a template and apply it to anything, and specifically in software sales, but just having a basic understanding of, you know, the science-based sales approach, seeing a value, and then going through the course and really having a, you know, being exposed to a little bit in one job, but just seeing how it can really help you out and help whoever you're trying to sell to out. And that's kind of, you know, added value there. It was kind of a no-brainer. Once I got in the middle, you know, once I committed to it, I was hungry to learn more. And so it wasn't like I ever got in the middle and thought, oh, damn, I'm wasting my time. Every day was more value. It kind of, you could see how it helped you. So it kind of, it was your own motivation to finish the course and get through it.
Great, man. And so we make some big promises when we like talk to our members. Was there any time where you were doubting us? Were you kind of skeptical? I know I was before the program. How did you feel about that?
No, initially it was kind of, it sounded kind of gimmicky, but at the same time, like doing, you know, some of the things they offered as far as just the approach is, some of it was some of the things I was doing kind of learning at a time. So I could see, I was like, hey, this is legit. I can see where there's value in it. So yeah, even though it kind of came across as gimmicky initially, like when I actually took the time to look at it, I could totally understand the value and knew kind of what I was missing and what I was doing. Because I felt like I was pretty successful at what I was doing, but I had no results. So ultimately, it's kind of like insanity. If you do the same thing over and over again, you know, it's with the same results, you know, it's not going to change. So that was kind of like, hey, this is, we have what you're missing. Just check it out. It's worth your time. And you know, especially when, you know, 90 days, it sounds kind of gimmicky, but when you're like, well, at least it's not like, hey, give us a year and we'll get you a job. No, it's you do the work, you get rewarded for it. So having that, like after, you know, researching it, that encouraged me to just take a step and do it.
All right on, man. And so actually doing it, how was that process? I worked with you through it. What did you think? Was it challenging? Was it easy? Was it tedious? Like, how did you feel about the actual process of going through the course?
No, I was, I took time while I was at my previous job. It's kind of one of those, not getting paid for the things you're selling. It kind of, I was like, you know, I'm going to spend a little time getting this done. So I was able to do more, probably than the average bear, you know, and I could do a lot more in the evenings, which was nice, but no, I never felt like it was overwhelming, even if it would have taken me an extra month. I mean, that's still a reasonable amount of time. And it's kind of one of those, the more you learn, the more you kind of want to consume, because you're each module, you're applying what you learned previously, and you get to see the kind of results and how it works, especially just doing things like putting a signature in your email. And then you get up to where you're creating a brand video of yourself, which that took a minute to kind of prepare or study what you're going to say, whether it's what Josh gave us or you come up with your own. Come up with that content took, you know, a few minutes, just because, hey, I'm broadcasting this. This is my brand. But it also, you know, it's a whole reason why you prepare. It's like you're trying to get that job. It's, you know, it's you're combining everything you learned. And so, I thought it was a reasonable workload, and they're always adding to it, so you can always go back and look at more. But I guess it could be tedious, but not really. I mean, it's, you have an hour or two a day, that's all it really takes.
That's great, man. Yeah, you did kind of blast through it. I didn't realize you had some downtime at work to do it, though. That's great, man. I know your job search was super short. Like, you kind of got started and then found a company you liked. So share your results with us.
That's the only thing. I didn't fully go through, sending out I sent sequences out, and, initially from a company I'd kind of talked to right when I started the program, and I stopped applying because, y'all tell us, hey, get to the program and then start applying. Well, they reached back out to me. And so, at a certain point, it just made sense. And so I went with that. But but having an understanding of, and the process behind, building the sequence, doing your ideal company profiles, that's huge value. And just knowing how to do that, and just, even if I had to start over, I feel comfortable in doing it. Knowing how to get a hold of people I need to get a hold of and get my message across, that's highly valuable. And I mean, obviously you can apply it to your job. That's what you're going to be doing. But I thought just the way you had it structured, it made sense. And I felt like if I needed to, I could get 6 or 7 interviews and have a choice, but it kind of just worked out really well with that initial company I talked to about, 40 days before. It just,
you had 7 interviews, but it was just with that one company, right?
Right. Yeah. Yeah. Eight interviews. So.
Jeez, man. Okay. And so if anyone's on the fence looking at pre-hire, do you have any advice for them?
Yeah, no, I mean, there's just think of, the way I looked at it with me is, if you're on the fence, you're at least thinking about it. So, evaluate why you're on the fence. What is it you're looking for? And, it's understandable to be skeptical of it, but it really works. And this is something that you can apply for the rest of your sales career if you choose to be in it. I think that is value in itself. It's a small price to pay. It's valuable information. It's invaluable. I mean, you could use that forever, and it can take you to where you need to go if you learn and apply it. So I would encourage anybody to try it out. What do you have to lose? And if you're thinking about it, you just got to evaluate your own situation. But I think for me, it was a no-brainer. And it really bridged the gap of where I need to get.
All right, Mike and Frisco, thank you so much. Appreciate you being with us.
Yeah, thanks, Kyle.